Respiratory illnesses in Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander children are serious, important, and the progression to chronic lung disease is mostly preventable. Respiratory conditions of concern among Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander children include both acute and chronic conditions. For acute conditions, these include acute respiratory infections like influenza and bronchiolitis. For chronic conditions, these include asthma and bronchiectasis. Currently, there is not a lot of data on the status of respiratory health among Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander children, but what we do know is that in 2012 to 2013, one-fifth of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander children had a long-term respiratory condition. In addition, in 2014-15, Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander children were up to 2 times more likely to be hospitalised for respiratory conditions compared to non-Indigenous children. Respiratory conditions contribute to the burden of disease for Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander children. Lower respiratory tract infections were the 8th leading contributor to the burden of disease for girls 5 years old and younger. Upper respiratory conditions were the 10th leading contributor for girls 5 to 15 years old. And asthma was a leading contributor to the total burden of disease for all Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander children. Risk factors for respiratory diseases include environmental factors like overcrowding and pollution, unhealthy diets, low birth weight, exposure to tobacco smoke, anemia, and socioeconomic status. There are many prevention strategies that can reduce the burden of respiratory disease for Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander children, including a focus on child lung health, improved infant health, healthy diet, reducing environmental tobacco smoke, vaccinations, prevention of smoking among young people, and education and empowerment of parents and carers. Respiratory diseases can have long-term impacts across the lifespan. Despite this, there is a lack of current available data. There is also a need for adequate data on children in urban and regional areas. This information will be crucial for ensuring programs, strategies, and interventions are relevant and acceptable. However, there is much that can be done now to enable Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander children to breathe easy through their lifetime.